recording. And that means that when this recording is on YouTube, people are going to hear me say art recording because I started it while I was in the middle of hitting the button. Why do I have three streams? Oh, that's right. I ran a stream for like 2 seconds earlier because it wasn't running. Talking about gens. Okay. Back in the day, I played tons of Streets of Rage on it. I've never played Streets of Rage. But you did give me that Steam game, Streets of Rogue. I'm thinking about streaming that in the next month or so. Did you play the Streets of Rage remake? I've never played any Streets of Rage. Alright, so 50 seconds into the recording, but 21 seconds into the stream, we are finally ready to play some Sonic 3D Blast Director's Cut, which oddly enough runs perfectly on this computer, or on this emulator, even though it's the Sega Genesis, like, Classics Edition. Oh man, look at that crispy looking Sonic. And the Streets of Rage remake is a fan project with absolutely unreal levels of polish. Streets of Rogue is like a completely different game. It's like Bird's View, Deus Ex on crack. Well, see, I've never played either, so I wouldn't know. But I do remember you giving me that game, so I will play it. In fact, I'll probably play it after I stream the other game you gave me next month. I'll just have like a double round of your game, your gifts on stream. So, what is this game exactly? It's a isometric 3D Sonic game that came out for the Genesis way back in 1996. It wasn't the best. It was neat. It had a lot of potential, but it wasn't great, much like a lot of the Sonic games that have come out since then. But the reason that I'm streaming this now is because a few months ago, the former founder of Traveler's Tales, John Burton, I think his last name is, he started a YouTube channel called Game Hut, where he goes into detail about a lot of the techniques and tricks that they use to program these old, not just Sonic games, because they also did Toy Story on the Genesis, they did Mickey Mania on the Genesis. You hope you could be there? Well, I mean, if anything, I'll see when you're available and then stream them then. So what was I saying? Yeah. So in the process of making these videos where he went into like depth about how he did all these cool visual tricks on the Genesis, because the Genesis was a very limited console. It did not have a lot of data on it, and the cartridges were very small. They did Toy Story on the SNES. They did Mickey Mania on the SNES as well. But I don't think Burton's team handled that. Anyway, in the process of making these videos, he found an old level editor, which is actually here, but it's really hard to use. I tried using it on the other version and it didn't work. And he had this idea to make a director's cut of Sonic 3D Blast, and that actually happened less than two months ago, and in that time, he compiled an entire patch that essentially improved the game. I think it tightened up the physics, it adds a level select screen, it adds a load game, which I believe allows you to use, password. Which, I don't know. I'm probably gonna have to use that later. Because this does not have save states. So it essentially allows you to save your progress through passwords, and it gave you better controls, and I believe he added Supersonic to the game as well, which was planned for the original version, but never happened. So, since I never played Sonic 3D Blast before in any real capacity, I have it on Sonic Mega Collection for the GameCube, which I've played, I think, all of 10 minutes of. I got to the second zone and gave up. I figured, you know, I'd show the man who's been going through all this trouble to, like, show all these secrets behind these games some respect, and stream this director's cut version that he made. And it's pretty cool. I like just the fact that he came out with his own version of this game. Now, how many years? 11 years after the original version came out is pretty awesome. So, original game, that sends you to the original unpatched version. Level editor is a kind of a basic level editor he had in the game in the, like, that he found in one of his videos, it doesn't let you save the levels, it just kind of lets you fuck around with, like, the various objects, including a couple unused things. Sound test, that's explanatory. Control, you could switch what the jump and spin dash buttons are. I believe I have A set to A on this, so jump should be A, and then B should be spin dash, yeah. Load game is password, new game is going to be just the new game, like the game with the patch applied to it. So, with all that said, let's start this up. After I untangle my cords here. So we get a little intro. Flickies are mysterious birds. They live in another dimension and can travel anywhere through large rings. Robotnik learns about the Flickies. I'll change the Flickies into robots and have them search for the Chaos Emeralds for me. Using the infinite power of the Emeralds, I can conquer the world! Yep, birds. The Flickies. Sonic visits Flicky Island to see his friends, but the only thing he finds are robots! Oh no. Look at that dead stare in his eyes. Robotnik made my friends like this. I must save them. Robotnik must be stopped. Sonic starts to defeat the enemies in order to rescue the Flickies, who are trapped inside. That's really all you get. Oh, and you get this. Go, Sonic! You can warp through the big rings with the help of the Flickies. Chase after Robotnik and defeat his plans. Wouldn't it be defeat him? Why defeat his plans? So that's all the story there is. Alright. Right away, I could tell that the controls are definitely a little tighter. Like, Sonic turns a lot quicker than he did in the original version. Let's see. Jump's normal. His color palette's a little different. I guess that's how you know, right? Ooh, what? Why? Okay, what? Okay, something's a little weird here. Do you have plans? Do his plans have a physical manifestation? That's what it sounds like. Alright, I'm kind of hitting a weird, like, error here. I'm not moving after, like, yeah, see, I just, like, stop. Okay, that's weird. The other thing wasn't having that problem. Let's see real quick. Joypad. Controller connected. Pad. Redefine keys. Three buttons. Up, down, left, right. Wait, can I? Up, down, left, right. Start. Mode? I guess I'll make that mode. A. C, B, spin dash, this will make that X, and then C will be B. And start will be that. Alright, that works better. Now, I actually mapped the control pad to the joystick instead, and it's letting me do multi-directional. Because what was happening before was, like, I'm just hitting left and right, and I would just stop. Alright, this works fine. Alright, so this is the game. It's top-down, isometric, 3D. I guess that wouldn't be top-down, that would just be isometric. So it is an action game. It honestly, the way it's presented makes me think of a Sonic version of Mario RPG. Because it's made by a third party. It's not a traditional Sonic game, just like Mario RPG is not a traditional Mario game, and uses isometric 3D. Only this is all platforming instead of platforming in, you know, RPG. So, you kind of just run around, you do shit, you kill enemies. But the way you play it is that the goal is every enemy you beat gives you a Flicky, and then what happens is you carry these Flickies over to a ring, and each ring that you beat will send you to another area of the level. There are 7 zones, each with 2 regular acts, and then 1 boss act. And then the boss act, you just kill the boss and that's it. There's an extra life, which uses the later Sonic, or the Sonic 3 extra, or continue noise. I can't be the only one who thinks of that Kirby golf game in the SNES when they see this level design. Oh no, not at all. With the checkerboards. That actually, I believe that's intentional. Like, I know that's kind of the Sonic aesthetic to have the checkerboards, but in this case, I think it helps because it lets you keep your bearings. Same with the shadow. So yeah, You could tell I've never really played this game. I played up to the second zone and stopped in the past. And that's, I was honestly, when John started his channel, I was actually like, oh man, I definitely would love to play Sonic 3D Blast now that, how did I not collect them? I would love to give Sonic 3D Blast a whirl now that, it's getting popular because of this guy talking about it. But, I ended up never doing it, and then he was like, oh, I'm gonna do a director's cut, and then I'm like, oh, you know what, I'm just gonna wait for that. So, here we are. Oh, shit. I lost one of my... Oh, no, I didn't lose my Flicky. I just lost my shield. That's one of the improvements he put in the game. You actually don't lose rings right away. You lose your Flickies first, and then you... And you lose your shield, then you lose your Flickies. And then you lose rings. Yeah, and as you can tell, a lot of the jingles and sound effects are borrowed from, like, Sonic 1, 2, and 3. There's Knuckles. Now, what I believe Knuckles and Tails do is that when you give them 50 rings, which you give them all your rings, you go to these bonus stages, and these get you Chaos Emeralds. Zero to go. Oh god, I gotta get more. Should have figured this is multifaceted. John actually also made a whole video about how these bonus stages were done. Like, the scrolling. See how, like, there's, like, multiple scrolling layers under you? There's actually a lot of, like, visual tricks that, they did to make that work. Kukles. Or Nukles. I got a Chaos Emerald. Now, the neat thing about the director's cut is that you're not pressured. I should move this back a little bit. Yeah, my new equipment, I have an audio interface with a big XLR cable sticking out of it, so it's kind of, kind of gets in the way at times. I guess he just cashes the rings in? I don't know what the point of that is. So a big thing with the director's cut is that, you can't grind all the emeralds at the beginning anymore. Like, in this game, it was kind of like Sonic 2 and Sonic 3, where you could just get all the emeralds as soon as you hit each special stage. This, I think you have to get one per world, but the upside is that because of the password system, it does save your progress, so you will not lose the emeralds you've gotten. Also, I think all the rings are back. Yeah, they are. So this is a checkpoint. What you do is you grab this, you put all the Flickies in. The more you have at once, the more points you get. And you stand on this, and it bumps you over to another area. I don't think that's a new area down there. And yeah, that's kind of what you do. You just rinse and repeat. Find the enemies, collect the Flickies, bring them to the ring, and go to the next area. One of the new additions that... Shit. There goes one. Oh, I lost my, did I lose my Flicky? No, I didn't. I just lost the, shield again. First off, he made those enemies easier. There were, like, things around it originally. Spike balls around each of those enemies. I don't know how to reach that. I believe, John, one of the new things he added to this version is he actually added in a time attack mode that you can access once you've beaten a zone completely, where you could go back and it's just a race to get to the goal ring as fast as possible. There's no Flickies to collect, it's literally just find the goal ring, run to it. C- controls are still a little loose, but I mean, it's pretty much as good as it's gonna get for this point. Did I get all of them here? Where am I? I guess not. There it is. Speed shoes. So I guess the fire shield makes you be able to do that. I can't remember doing that otherwise. There we go. And that's Act 1 beaten. So there's a Tails bonus too, because Tails also shows up on the field. He works the same way though. Oh, see, here you go. See? So I got my save. It gives you a completion percentage too, which is really nice. And I don't know what that Sonic icon means underneath it. Maybe that means I've beaten it time attack wise. Let me try. I don't know if I'll do time attack on stream. If this game takes more than like 2 levels, so I could actually time challenge or just replay the level. The bumper. Maybe that Sonic thing was the thing you didn't reach. Nah, that just looked like an extra life. I think. Maybe it's all the extra lives on a stage? Fuck. I died because I didn't have any rings. Let's get another shot. Yeah, but I'm probably going to do the time challenges on my own. I just want to show it off because it is a new feature of this version of the game. It is a little hard. I mean, like, the controls are very floaty, so doing a time trial of this is not the easiest thing in the world, but... Time over. Wait, what? Did I die? Was there an actual time limit, or... Oh, there is. You only got 30 seconds. Shit. What's about Sonic ROMs being the most modded of them all? I don't know. I mean, I've played... There are Battle Network. There are millions of Battle Network ROMs that have been hacked. But I mean, that's the other thing too. Is this really a hacked ROM? Because at this point, it's the original creator putting his own stuff in the game. Yeah, I died due to time over. Wow, that's a tight time limit. Is there a way to increase the amount of time you have? You don't even get any for hitting a checkpoint. Kind of ridic. But I did it with 1 second left. Oh, and it saves your overall score as well. That's cool. Well, all that happened was that changed. Huh. It does count as a completion percentage though, so... If I want to 100% this game, I'm going to be doing all that. There's a really cool mod for X3 where Zero is a fully playable character. That's pretty neat. I could definitely see myself giving that a whirl at some point. I loved playing as Zero in X4. But anyway, let's continue. You don't have to bring all 5 Flickies to the goal at the same time, but doing so gets you more points, obviously. Did you play X3? I've played X1 through 6. And next year when they come out on the Switch, I'll play X7 and X8, finally. Even though X7's garbage. These slope physics are a little weird. Like, going down a slope, you're still kind of slowing down a bit. Oh, I got all five, cool. Whee! So yeah, in regards to streaming, this is my second to last stream of the year. After today, there will be one more. It'll either be tomorrow, Saturday, or Sunday. Because honestly, I've got nothing going on this weekend. It could be any of those 3 days. There's nothing I gotta do in the evening. As long as I don't go past midnight on New Year's. Because, I mean, who's gonna be around for that? Or New Year's Eve, rather. That's what I meant. They bounce zero saber too, so it's pretty strong, but not a downright one-hit kill like in the other version. Instead of gold armor, Zero gets his black armor, cutscenes have been altered too, etc. I mean, that's the thing, keeping Zero alive or destroying him has a pretty significant impact on how the story unfolds, at least as far as I remember. Oh. You doubt you could be here on Saturday? Oh, alright, well, I'm going to aim for tomorrow so I could take Saturday, Sunday, and Monday off and then return Tuesday the 2nd or Wednesday the 3rd or whatever. The point is, I just want to get one more stream out of me this week so that I can be all like on top of it. Because I got to do two streams this week and I got to make up an extra 15 minutes that I didn't make up before. Hey, it's Tails. What do you want, buddy? Take my rings. Oh, maybe you do get multiple special stages per world. I don't know how I was so bad at this when I was younger. I mean, when I got this game on the Sonic Mega Collection, I was still in high school at the time, so it's like I couldn't have been that bad. My tiny baby gamer brain had already developed to be able to do this. No, I lost rings. I lost my chicken rings. Or my onion rings. Are chicken rings a thing? Chicken nuggets are a thing. Oh, I see, it's just an extra life. Whee! Whoa, that flashing. What was up with that? Also, you can't really see it on the stream, but there is a life kind of flashing. No, stop. Deep fried chicken booty holes. Oh, so, Slim Jims. Slim Jims are mechanically separated chicken, which means it's butts and beaks. Little slowdown happening on my end. I don't know why. Getting a couple flashes too. I don't understand what that's about. Eh. Yeah, the slopes kind of kill your momentum in this game. That fire shield is useful, though. Oh, there's something hidden over here. Mechanically separated sounds like a very technical-sounding term for the meat we collected while scrubbing the floor in the production hall. I mean, that's pretty much what it is. You think Slim Jim is using the A-quality meat? You think they're bringing their A-game? I think I just blasted myself back to Area 1. Oh, I see. The flickies can grab extra lives, too. Alright. So having more flickies means that you kind of bounce, you have like a higher tail to you. Pretty sure things like Biffy are the same though. Is it pronounced Biffy? B-I-F-I? Where's the exit? There it is. We got more of this level. Wow, did I ever actually get to Rusty Ruin? Because man, this level's taking forever. How did I ever get past this as a kid? Also, yeah, spoilers, Rusty Ruin's the next zone. By the way, Act 1, some of the best music on the Sega Genesis, in my opinion. It's such a good song. I can't wait to get to it, actually. It's pronounced Beefy. Oh. See, because I'm used to the word Wi-Fi, which is W-I-F-I. So B-I-F-I makes me think of Bi-Fi. It's like how bike is short for bicycle. And Mike is short for Michael Raffone. A true Sega music connoisseur likes the Doom OST on Sega 32X. Fart Doom. Oh, you mean like the basement in the PS1 director's cut of Resident Evil 1? Alright, I thought maybe getting the extra life would give you the extra life head down there, but it clearly does not, so... Alright, and I see the clock is shady. Or blinky, if you don't have, if you don't beat the time on it. Alright, I think Act 3 is just a boss. Yep. Better grab some rings. Alright, that hurts. Maybe don't do that. I guess that hurts it? This, yep, there we go. This kills the Eggman. Or damages him and severely inconveniences him. Wow, you need to be precise with those bonky donks. Wrecked. All right, there we go. Rusty Ruin. So there's no Sonic Head on that stage, nor is there Time Attack. It's only Acts 1 and 2, so the boss stages are just boss stages. Bossu time. Duke can build robots that do everything for him. Why does he even need to conquer the world? Because that's what rich people do. Haven't you been paying any attention to Elon Musk at all? What has he done aside from have a shitload of money? Nothing. Yet he thinks he has a say in how the world goes. Alright, ready for some awesome banging music? Because that's what you're getting here. Can I go in here? Yeah, I can. Nothing to see, though. Oh, hey, there was an extra life in there. Neat. Bump, bump-a-dump, bump-a-bump-bump. What does that do? I was super rich. I would stream video games all day and shitpost on furry Twitter. So, you mean, like any furry that has money. You don't need to be super rich to do that. Whoa. Okay, I'm twirling. Oh, that makes me be able to break shit. That wasn't smart. That looked like a door, though. Wait, was that a flick? Oh, no. It was a gator, which has a flicky in it. I don't even know how much I would charge... That would... I don't even know how much would change for me, except that I would have more consoles and stuff. Well, I see... I don't know. B. I just killed Charmy. Get angry, internet. Oh, I lost all my rings. What? No. I can't use money to get rid of my personal issues. Yeah, that's true. Well, remember, we're living in a new age now. People are starting to realize that money is kind of bullshit in general. Honestly, I'm starting to realize that outside of just being able to buy stuff that I want, I'd have no personal use to have a lot for having a lot of money. Like, it's like, oh, you can live comfortably. It's like, yeah, but if a lot of the issues that are plaguing this world weren't an issue to begin with, I wouldn't need it. Period. I still believe in earning money to buy luxury items, that's fine. It's just like, why do I have to pay to exist? That feels like kind of a dick move on the world's part. I think... What I would like is to have the means to support other people while not having to worry about supporting myself. And if I want something, you know, I could just have it. You know, I could save up for a couple days and earn it. While at the same time not having to worry about me or any of my friends, you know, dying on the fucking street. Yeah, exactly. The world didn't ask for me to exist, and I didn't ask the world to exist. So stop expecting shit out of me. I believe that enemy was unused originally. That enemy was not in this game initially, and John added it back in. I remember the crab being like a big... come on! With those friggin' traps. Oh wow, they're... Oh god damn it! I was gonna say, wow, that's clever. The fire shield actually does block fire attacks. This level. Come on. Oh, it really annoys me that this looks like there's, like, paths there and there's not. World is a fuck. Yeah, I love that shirt. There have been so many memes involving that shirt. Am I back at the beginning? I'm back at the beginning! Didn't I already clear this area out? You... motherfucker. Okay. Where's the exit here? Also, where's the last, enemy. Wait, I'm back at the beginning again. How'd that happen? Oh, the statues, okay. damn it. Oh my god. Okay. At least the flickies create a buffer. What about bootlegged English stuff that may- What is it about bootlegged English stuff that makes it so appealing? It's just funny, really. I mean, I'm sure people make fun of, I'm sure people make fun of English speakers when they can't properly speak another language. Just human nature, really. Alright. How's this gonna work? Are you kidding me? Come on! Alright. Oh my god. This level, poorly designed. It's no wonder I only liked the music and nothing else of this level. Oh, come on, man. Get caught on one and then immediately bang into the next one. I wish, you know, of all the fixes he made to the momentum, fixing the spinning one would have been a little nice of a move to, you know. It would have been very much appreciated. That's what I mean to say. And there goes the ball. There come my flickies. Where even is the exit here? I haven't found it yet. Level sucks. Just go down. Come on. Come on. There we go. Where's this? Oh, I see. You know what? Better break those. Just to make sure I can get back here. Can't help but giggle when I see someone comment on what appears to be Google translated German. That's how I talk in multiple languages. I rely on Google Translate. Though, to be fair, I mostly do that in Japanese, and, I know enough Japanese to fix grammatical errors if there's any glaring ones. It's mostly just for vocabulary reasons, because I don't know most kanji and most Japanese terms, but I know basic sentence structure, so I know if something looks off. Doing this stage in time attack is going to be a fucking nightmare. Oh, there's no time up in this game. I hit the max and I'm still going. I took a licking and I'm keeping on ticking. Where do I go from here? Woohoo! Time taken, too long. Thanks, game. Oh, I can't even do time attack because I didn't beat it in under 10 minutes. I wonder if there's a time limit for Act 3. Nope, whatever. I think my focus tonight will just be playing through the game as far as possible, since I don't have to limit myself to getting everything as I go along. And then next stream, I'll focus on finishing the emeralds and beating the game, and then any remaining time will be dedicated to doing time attack. But I don't think... I don't see this lasting more than two streams. Bam. If I stop hitting stuff, do I still keep spinning? Oh, I do! I thought it just wears off if you stop moving. Secrets? No. No pep secrets in this level. No, that's not true. There might be. Oh, there's... See? There's stuff. Oh god, bouncy pads. Flame shield, which just lets me fire straight down. Or so I thought. Wait. Huh. That's weird. Alright, never mind. Guess I was wrong. What? Oh, please don't tell me this is... Oh, I fell. Shit. Alright. Also, I don't know why this flame shield doesn't let me do the bounce. That's weird. Yeah, this floor is a little too steep. Don't you cap on me. Oh, I see. Oh, here's another change he made. On moving platforms like that, your speed is dramatically reduced. And it's very helpful, because then you don't accidentally run straight off. Okay, there's gonna be flames coming out of that shit. No, oh, God, fucking, that was, oh, why? I don't deserve that kind of treatment. Whoop! I dropped my SpaghettiOs. The nice thing about the special stages in this game is that if you find Knuckles or Tails and you give them the rings, they stay with them. So, you don't lose them after that. Jump. I feel like something's wrong with the jumping right now. I last few days I have that Kami Comes to Visit video from Vinny on my mind. Kami Comes to Visit? Is that an older one? I don't remember that. Where the hell are Tails and Knuckles on this zone anyway? I don't think I've met them yet. Or maybe I met Tails in the last stage and missed him. It's pretty old. Where Vinny yells, "Damn it, you dropped the spaghetti." See, dropping the spaghetti is an old term. I've been hearing that for like... Hello? Flicky. I've been hearing that for at least 7 years or more. The rare double flick. God, no. Really gotta look out for that shit. Oh, come on, really? Oh, one of my flickies got knocked. Got him. Alright. You're now back in positive flicky fucking, I don't know. What am I even saying? I don't know what I'm trying to say. I don't know what emotions I'm trying to convey. And we're back in Quaction. God, why are these levels so big? This is ridiculous how hard this is to do. Alright, that's not what I was looking for. Let me guess, this is back at the beginning? Yep. I was hoping this would be a path to, like, Tails or something, but... Nope. Never mind. What the hell? Did I run into Tails or Knuckles once in this zone? Whatever. I mean, this game isn't too short. It's 7 zones, but each of these acts are taking me like 10 minutes to beat. So can I not... No, I can't do... Do I need to actually beat these before I could do them? Maybe that's why. Also, remind me to write down the password at the end. Because I'm not going to remember it. If I'm not mistaken, this boss theme is partially the inspiration for one of the boss themes from Sonic Mania. It's like impossible to not get hit there. And I died. It was my first death. Alright, so just ramming into that thing hurts. See, now would be the ultimate upgrade to this game. Doing a, like a Mario Advance style voice clip add-in. So every time you jump, it's like, woo, woo, yeah. Spring Stadium. In Vinny's Sonic voice. I think Roger Craig Smith does a great Sonic. Okay. So those are all springs, but I have to jump to activate them. I think. Or not. Oh, never mind. Just that one is a spring. I guess bouncies? Yep. Alright, so this is literally the casino zone of the game. Even the music kind of sounds casino-y. This is fun, but that was a lot of, like, autoplay fluff. That's kind of common in Sonic games. Where they do that thing where it's like, oh, the game kind of just plays itself here. Congrats, you played yourself. Oh, don't want to stand on that. Yep. Where the fuck are the enemies here? There's one. This is incredibly disorienting. Yeah, those segments are cookie clicker. God, this is massive. There, popping the balloons does nothing. I do like the sense of exploration in this game. Like, these levels are big. There's a lot to look at. If you're going for everything, there's going to be secrets to explore. And you know, if you're playing this version and you're gonna go for 100%, you need to learn the routes so that you can not fuck up getting to the exit in time. Oh man, down the pipe. There we go. Like, look at this. They even went through the trouble of putting in, like a transparent section there that you could kind of see Sonic go through. Like, they really went overboard with the visuals in this game, I feel. They wanted to push the Genesis to its limits. There's Tails. I might as well give him my rings. 29. How many gave him? 29? Alright, so I'm not at 30 yet. How many do I need to go to the special zone? Might be 50. 50! There we go. We gotta get dangerously close to the edge in this. Few more to go. Got it. Nice. If I want to have a game that plays itself, I'd play Clicky Clicker. Good point. Good point. I was never big on Clicky Clicker. I never played it that much. I know it got like super advanced and there was like a lot of updates for it, which I find is ridiculous. It's ridiculous that a game like that became like such a huge deal. And I know people that still kind of play it too, which is ridiculous. Which in itself is more ridiculous rather, because I already said ridiculous once. I gotta say, the game is very forgiving about hitting enemies, which is very nice in a game like this. Hey, there's Canucks. The only thing that made me play Cookie Clicker for a short while was the SMBX contest level that Vinny played. Oh, I remember that level. That level was incredible. Moist cookies. Spoon Mario. No! Don't make me take damage here. That little peeping noise the Flickies make when they go in the ring, it reminds me of the beginning of Fletchinder's Cry from Pokemon. I can't do it. Also, I was doing a different Pokemon there. I guess I gotta beat the time attack on stage 1 to do stage 2. Because it's just not showing up. 14% done. Not bad. See, the nice thing now is because of the way this game is structured in the director's cut, once you got a Chaos Emerald, you don't have to worry about any of the other ones for that zone. You can just kind of blast through it. Like for me now, rings are just for points or for, just for points and, you know, safety. I do find it funny that all the... Shit, I knew that was there and I walked right into it anyway. I find it funny, though, that there's spiders here that have spikes on their back, and yet that doesn't affect your ability to jump on them at all. Oh my god, please, just let me grab the flickies. Are we disoriented yet? We gotta vomit? Oh man, speaking of vomiting, guess what game I played today? I'll give you a hint, it's short, it's scary, and it has to do with high school. Yep, you got it. No, that's not the actual name of the game, though. You're confusing it with Mario 2 on the NES, the Japanese version of it. I don't believe there was... Why Sonic and... Tails and Knuckles, what are you doing over here? Just hanging out? Can I hang out with you? So what do you guys do over here? Do you just stand here? Spikes, they do nothing. I interrupted something private, yeah. Tails and Knuckles were having a moment. I think I'm realizing why I didn't beat this game as a kid. It's not because it was too hard, it's just so disorienting to look at. Oh, I'm not even in the right spot. I'm aiming for, like, the out-of-bounds area. Oh my god, why did I have to lose a flicky here? Please, just come to me. There we go. Come to me again. There we go. Flicky, come on. And the scary thing is, this director's cut version actually makes it easier for the flickies to recover, for, like, come to you after you lose them. So, what does that tell you about how the original game was? Gotta do here. Portable version of Blast must have been a nightmare. Was there a portable version of Blast? I remember Sonic Labyrinth for the Game Gear. Oh, I see. I gotta turn left. Okay. There we go. Oh, got them all. Nice. Okay, we're donezo. I know of Sonic Labyrinth on the Game Gear, which was... It was kind of done in this style, but it was... The plot was different, and the way it controlled was different. And it also was not fun. This, at least, I'm getting some semblance of enjoyment out of. Robotnik did not... the plot... No, the plot of the Sonic Labyrinth was that Robotnik somehow stuck slow shoes on Sonic, and you had to go through these really... Like, you had to collect keys to open a door in each little labyrinth, and the labyrinths were, like, hard to navigate because you couldn't go fast. The whole point of the game was that Sonic could not go fast, aside from spin dashing. And dead. Probably the best plan Robotnik ever had. Yeah, make Sonic slow. There you go. I can't stop you. Unless you're Knuckles, then you could just punch him. Or Tails, and you could just fly. I wish the rings would stay on screen slightly longer after you lose them. But I guess that might make this game a little too easy. Also, flashing, please stop. Oh my god, he's not dead yet. Why does he have so many hits? There we go. Diamond Dust. Sorry, before I go on to that, I need to take a quick second here. Played the video I sent earlier for the break. No, I'm not taking a break. I just needed to take care of it because I got a text that I needed to take care of. I keep getting followed by a bunch of indie game promoters on Twitter, and I think they don't realize that I'm not an indie game developer. Water tastes stagnant. I gotta replace it. Alright, what do we got? Diamond Dust. Ooh, this is another good song. You might remember it as the song from the critically acclaimed BioWare game Sonic Chronicles, where it was presented in the worst MIDI format imaginable. What up, Nux? Take my rings. Take my wife. No, seriously. The start of Ken Pender's OC drama. That wasn't the start of it. It was definitely a major contributing factor to it, though. Actually, maybe it is the start. I can't remember. Might be enough. I had 32 before, right? Yeah. Look at the double ding. Probably because I jumped through the rings or something. Or the goalpost. No. Oh, no, 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 no. That's not good. These stages are getting a little tight here. Three down. Not 100% knowledgeable on that specific topic, but it didn't start like it. It didn't start it. It's like you said, it's a very important part of it, yeah. Ooh, look at that Sonic slip right there. Penguin, and it's dead. This. I guess it's nothing. Not one of my flickies. Never really read the comics before I've seen online. Some crazy shit went down. Yeah. I mean, ugh. I don't know everything, and I still don't want to think about it. Wait, am I back down a layer? Yeah, I am. He's not a nice man. Whoops. Oh, hey. Look at that. Wonder if that was supposed to happen. Interesting, it doesn't hurt you, but that also takes away your shield if you have one. For example, I have a really hard time believing this was in any actual official comic at the time. Let me see. I'm getting a bad link there. You might want to check that. That's not popping up for me. You asked. I was like on a perfect little spin there, and you fucked me. Dingus. I don't know, it gave me an oops wrong page error. Oh yeah, look at those rings. We don't need them, but look at them. Alright, we gotta Tokyo drift our way back over here. You know what they say about Sonic? You ain't out of control. You ain't in control. Let's get home in on enemies, too. Bam. Weird, it works for me. You'll send it in Telegram. Okay. I only have one flicky. Where are the rest? There's two. I lost my shield! Oh no, there it is. What the? Okay, that was weird. I guess the flicker at 30 frames a second is just kind of weird. My room's getting hot. This whole house freezes, but my room, when the heat's on, gets ridiculously hot, and I hate it. Did it work? Oh, I didn't check. Yeah, I saw it. There it goes. Tails being given the moral dilemma of whether or not to murder Robotnik with a gun. I mean, look, the comic did a lot of stupid shit. That is not the first time that comic did something like that. Also, hold on one second. I'm taking my sweater off, or my hoodie, which is a new hoodie, by the way. My mom gave it to me for Christmas, and it's really comfortable. But I'm taking it off, because, man, it is getting hot in here. Ugh. My ear is crackling now. Because I pulled that thing over my headphones, and it staticked it. By the way, I still sound fine, right? My volume's okay, like mine and the game's. Because I'm still trying to work out the new microphone settings. I know you said it was right before, I just want to make sure that like you could still hear me when I'm away from the mic a little bit. Okay. Alright, Diamond Dust. Act 2. This is the halfway point, I think. I said that Ken Penders is going to go to IDW, who are the new people, because Archie no longer makes the Sonic comics. Now it's going to be IDW, which they handle a lot of properties, like all the Hasbro stuff, that's them. So they're going to have, Ken Penders is going to go over there with like a shaved mustache. He's going to call himself Pen Kenders. Claim it's an original name, and if anyone tries to steal it, he will sue the shit out of them. And then he'll be fired immediately. Or they won't hire him in the first place. I really can't sit properly like this anymore because this cable's now in the way. I'm gonna have to move this. I could do this, I guess. How's that? That's better. It's different when I'm recording something, because when I'm recording something... Wait, what did I open anyway? Oh, I went through that portal. It's different when I'm recording, because when I'm recording, my arm's not on the table. But here I'm, like, kind of trying to relax a bit. I think the entire drama that played out, they'd be morons to hire him. Yeah, no, I don't think anyone's hiring him anymore. He's doing his own thing now. Unless there's contract disputes, I don't know. That section was really short. I have not moved yet. I didn't want to go to another bonus stage. I have a million lives. Whoops! Oh, wait, what? Oh, you actually can't fall off. Alright. What if I just stay on a wall? So, you don't lose time by hitting that, and you also can't fall off the sides. So this is a lot easier than I thought it'd be. Ow, my friggin' arm. Also, there's no time limit, so... Alright, but hitting that makes you lose. What's this? What's over here? Oh, it's extra life. Neat. Extra life. Extra wife. That's an old reference right there. Can I jump up there? No, I can't. Oh, that's dangerous. That hurts. Wait, what? I lost my flickies. How'd that happen? That enemy up there is, like, ramming me when I land on the platform. Okay. Asshole. Mmm, 22% done. Alright, this seems a little easy. Oh, wait, you know he's so high up now, shit. See, this is kind of, like, they were actually kind of smart about this. You can't just stand underneath them and jump up into them. You have to hit them from the top, or it does not count. Favorite corruption was either Sesame Street, Fuck You, You're Dead, or Satan Cart. Satan Cart's a classic. Honestly, I've been watching less and less of Vinny lately. And that's not like... That's not like an insult against him or anything. I've either just been too busy or I haven't had the time. Well, not even, I just said that's same with not being too busy, I guess. I just, I don't know. Some of the games you've been streaming haven't been interesting me that much lately, and I've had too much other stuff to focus on. So I've just been like, I'll just skip a stream and either go to bed early or watch something else that I've, been behind on. Which, I mean, is fine. You know, if you'd said that to him, he'd be like, yeah, that's fine. You should watch what you want. Don't watch my streams. Hand of Fate 2 is amazing. That's actually what I've been skipping out on a lot of. I've watched a few streams of it, but it's like, there's nothing I'm going to miss by not watching some, so it's like, if I'm busy, I'm just going to be like, I'll skip Hand of Fate 2. And I've also been skipping the Zelda DLC because I don't want that spoiled for me. Volcano Valley. I don't know how far I am into this now. Yeah, no, I'm not watching it. I'm saving that for never. So, fun fact, in Japan, there's actually a downloadable, or there was a downloadable version of this game that you could get on the old, like, Sega Net or whatever it was called, and it was actually split into two halves, and that's where the idea to get the password system in this director's cut came from, because it was implemented in the Japanese downloadable version, and this is where you'd start from in part two, this zone. And because of the password system being used here, John was like, oh, I can implement that into the full game and just add a pseudo-save system with it. No. Did you hear about X-Band? What was that? That was an Xbox, right? I know about it. I've heard of it. I just don't remember what it was. This looks like there's a hidden goodie over here. Yep. Called it. Really? Okay, well, that flicky's just over there now, so... And now that flicky's about to go back. Why is this flicky being so hard to get here? Ooh, here we go. Traps. As an add-on for the Super Nintendo, they play multiplayer online via phone line. You know what? I remember that. That was a thing in America for a while. You could play Mario Kart online with it. There's also Satellaview, which let you download stuff on the Super Nintendo. That was only in Japan, though. What the hell? Oh, I was gonna say. Why am I at a dead end here? Ugh, oh my god. It's unfortunate, but even with the tighter controls, this game is still really loose. And very frustrating to deal with. Come on. See, like, I should not have crashed into the lava there. I feel like that was way too loosey-goosey of the controls to do. What's this? Oh. Okay, neat. X-Band had a subscription service, and all supported games had to be reverse-engineered to make online play even possible. Yeah, and Satellaview was just an official thing. I gotta say, the game does a good job of having a very Sonic-like feel to it. Even though the ground looks the same in every area, it's like the atmosphere definitely has like a Sonic-ish feel to how it's presented. just thinking that some nerds way back then had stuff all figured out to the point where they made online play possible blows my mind. Yeah, I mean, it's ridiculous how far some technologies have come, but at the same time, like, we had online play, we had internet, we had all that stuff back in the 90s. It was just so primitive that we never really thought much of it at the time. We didn't think it would get as far as it does. Or go as far as it is, rather. Tails over here? That'd be nice. Nope, guess not. Ooh, I like that. That first note right there sounded like something out of Echo the Dolphin. That's another game I've never played, by the way. I've heard that game is brutally difficult. Okay, and you can walk in that. Note to self, don't walk in it. You don't trust dolphins. Dolphins are pretty aggressive creatures. Like, really, they are very aggressive creatures. They seem nice on the surface, and wow, look at that. Oh no, never mind, that looks fine. I thought that square was kind of hovering above the ground for a bit. They say you could trust them, then you get viruses. Oh, I know what you're talking about. I'm gonna say, what, are you talking about the emulator? Because that's, Dolphin emulator's never betrayed me in that capacity. Wait, I could just walk through these with a shield. Holy shit. God, the fire shield in this level is ridiculous. It's almost necessary. Talking about betrayal and emulators. What? Where are you going with that one? Remember that version of Project 64 that came with malware? Oh, yeah. Honestly, I've never used Project 64 before, nor have I tried any N64 emulation, because it just doesn't run right on my computer. And also, apparently N64 is a notoriously hard system to emulate. Even the good emulators can't do it that well. What was up with that? I don't know. Creators being dicks? It's the same thing with that one Sonic fan game that was here a few weeks ago that we mentioned a couple streams back. Damn it. Where's Tails, or Knuckles, or Big the Cat, or I don't know. Big the Cat didn't exist yet. Where's Amy? I have a pretty bad version of P64 now. I guess it wasn't for that, I would have tried Mario 64 online, but out by now. Damn it, Flicky. Thank you. I just leave the ROM hacks and stuff to other people, usually. Wasn't Amy's first appearance in Sonic CD? That is true. And Tails' first appearance was Sonic 2. And they were both developed at the same time. So two mainstays of the series were developed for two different iterations of classic Sonic at the same time. Tails is better than Amy. It's a playable character? Yeah, I definitely agree. I mean, Amy was playable in the Sonic Advance games, and she wasn't too fun. Come on, one of these lead to a friggin' bonus area. Because I have the rings. I have the technology. I feel like that's just gonna lead me back down. Oh, cool. It's Nux. Jesus, okay. This isn't so bad. That's a little worse. Nailed it. Oh, I lost my shield though. I mean, this is all the way back to the beginning. No. Thankfully, that's another little quality of luff. Quality of life upgrade in this version. When flickies are off screen, you get kind of an indicator to tell you where they are. To the grind. It'd be nice if I didn't fall off the platform. Where am I? What is this? I was honestly a bit disappointed by forces. I mean, everyone was. And ended up not living up to the hype. I still want to play it though, honestly. Not gonna lie. Well, the thing is, Mania wasn't really made by wasn't made by Sonic Team. It was made by a group, you know, the Headcanon Games, or the indie devs. I did not watch anyone on VineSauce play Sonic Forces. I watched my friend Gamma play it. It's a group of ROM hackers, yeah, sorta. Boss time. Is this arena any bigger? Yeah, it is. Okay, but we can't see it. That's kind of weird. How's this work? Okay. So I can't jump straight onto him. I have to jump on these? Yeah, it looks like it. Beb. Yep. I'm really confused about how this works. It's so hard to judge, like, gauge your jump on this. Okay. I think I got it. Twenty-six seconds. I mean, there's really only one there's one outcome for that battle. You either cheese it or you don't, or you lose. Honestly, I'm tempted to go back to Rusty Ruin just to get the Chaos Emerald at this point. But doing these stages are such a pain. I'll go back when I finished it. Or should I? You know what? I got time. Emerald. Alright. Ring. More ring. More ring. Ring. Rings! I don't know if I have to beat the stage or not after getting the emerald. Oh my god. Fuck you. Can I exit out? No, I can't. There's Tails too, shit. So he's like right at the beginning. What do I think about GPM? He's a nice dude. Actually, honestly, I like GPM streams a lot. I'll watch him whenever he's doing something I'm interested in. Alright, I see what I have to do here. I have to free Tails. Mario Galaxy Repainted. Yeah, that was a good stream. Oh wait, no, never mind. I can't free Tails. Not from there, at least. Let's see. Whoa. You mother shittin' piece of garbo. Okay. You know what? Maybe a redo on the stage is necessary. If only it were easy to actually die. I can't believe there's no way to back out of a stage. Of all the things that the guy adds to this game, that couldn't have been one of them. Also, I'm really annoyed that hitting that spoke fucking makes you lose rings. What a load of crap. Oh my god, I actually can't leave. I mean, the upside is that all the rings are back, so I can recollect them, but... it's also like, do I want to bother? But the answer is yes. Yes, I do. Fuck. It's trash. That's enough. Are you fucking kidding me, mate? All right. It's fine. Speaking of Breath of the Wild, don't think you'll be starting that up again. You're pretty Breath of the Wild out. Outed. Or Breath of the Wilded. Did you play on the Wii U, I'm guessing? Because you don't have a Switch, right? Played on the Wii U. So I have a question. Was any of the stuff on the touchpad or on the gamepad at all? Or was it all on the screen? Because I heard that there was going to be extensive touchpad support for Breath of the Wild, and then it got all canned because the Switch version was like, nah, let's switch it down to one screen. Okay. Just gotta take this slow. Don't hit anything. Alright, good. We did it. Fucking finally, dude. Onion rings acquired. You're one of those special. There wasn't that much touchpad stuff. I'm one of the special ones that actually wasted a lot of time collecting the Koroks. To be fair, I collected over half of them. I got all the upgrades for my inventory. I was thinking about when I eventually go back and do the DLC, because I haven't gotten either of them yet, that I would do Pack 2, Pack 1, and then also go for the remaining Koroks once I got the mask for it. Though, that's probably a huge undertaking that I probably am not going to want to bother with. Alright, I just got to beat this nightmare of a stage. With good music, admittedly. That's all you really should do. It's really not worth collecting all of them. I know, you get a giant piece of turd for getting them all. Literally, a giant turd. See, those things on the wall are really annoying because they're just at the right height to hit you. Mask wasn't even in the game when you did it. I mean, it wasn't when I did it either. I got 460 something of them, and it wasn't, and I did that on my own. Alright, I gotta break this piece of shit. Some of them are stupidly well hidden, I know. It is worth it when you find one, though, and you feel accomplished that you found one. You know what? I'll come back for you. I will admit, Breath of the Wild's overworld, even with all the Koroks, it is a little empty at times. And I'm hoping that, you know, they're already working on the next Zelda game, which is great. I'm hoping that they tighten it up a bit. Make the world map maybe a little smaller, but pack more stuff to do in it. Because that's something that I feel Mario Odyssey did really well. The world maps were big. They weren't overbearingly big, but they were packed with shit to do. And it made exploring every inch of it worth it. Gerudo Highlands was pretty bad. Pretty bland, rather. Sorry, not bad. Kind of agree. I definitely think it's weird that there was so many ice areas in the game. We had the northern, the north, west area. We had the eastern area, which was right next to a beach, and then we had the area right next to the desert, which makes a little sense, but also felt like we didn't really need it. And there wasn't a whole lot there either, in the tundra. The east, the Lanayru province, where Mount Lanayru was. God, I don't care. Let me just finish this level and get this nightmare over. Done. And it took less than 10 minutes this time. Cool. So we got the emerald here now, finally. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we got two more zones to go. And I've got about a little less than an hour left before I'm going to stop streaming for tonight. I got to remember to write down my password before I finish. Gene Gadget. Oh my god, you actually went through the trouble of upgrading all your armor? God damn, dude. And I thought I played that game obsessively. Something here? Can I go in there? Hold on, my nose is itchy. There we go. Nope. The answer is a resounding no. Oh, that thing just doesn't stop firing, does it? Ooh, okay. Those light up. Wow. And there it goes. Lost it already. No, oh. I was like, oh, wait, can I jump on that? No. My favorite area... Your favorite armor was the barbarian one. Had a pretty neat effect and it looked sweet. Let me tell you, attack up in Breath of the Wild is so broken. If you have an attack up level 3, which the barbarian armor would give you at full upgrade, it would break the game pretty much. Because the damage formulas in that game were very flat damage. It was pretty much your damage minus the enemy defense was how much you did to them. So you just had a high enough attack and it would not matter at all. Sorry, I got a little distracted for a second. What am I doing here? I need the emerald, and I need to beat this stage. God, it'd be amazing if I just ran into Tails or Knuckles, like, right now. Photos of the plants were actually really easy. Once you got them, you could just drop them and make a picture. Well, a lot of them were like that. Animal, and not animals, the weapons, the armor. I just bought a lot of it too, because rupees were easy to come by. Nothing here. Oh, you motherfuck. Oh, well, whatever. It doesn't matter. If the gang ain't anywhere around here, it ultimately does not matter. So, in addition to this right now... No, don't go in there yet. Real bombs were actually pretty BS since star fragments were so ridiculous to get. Yeah, farming them was a pain. Can you just give me the win there? Like, just let me hit the enemy without fucking blowing it. What? Did it put me back at the beginning? Why the hell did it do that? Star fragments, they were easy to farm if you knew how, but they were very slow. You'd get one a day. And then you'd have to, like, reset the timer and do it again. Because you can only get one a night. But there was a way to, like, maximize their appearance. Okay, just... collect. And there's old Nux, right where I didn't want him to be. We might be able to pull this off, though. I think we will. Alright, had to not blow the special stage. Alright, hold on, I'll get to your comment in a sec. I gotta focus on this. Oh my god, look how many bombs there are. Alright, we're good, I think. As long as I don't crash a bunch of times. Like that! Fuck. Alright, we're good. One of the few Amiibo armors that didn't need Star Fragments was Fierce Deity, you believe. Let me tell you, when I found out that that was an armor in the game, I was like, and that, because that, was that wasn't one that you could get initially. That was one of the ones locked behind newer Amiibo that came out after Breath of the Wild came out. I was like, oh man, if they make a Fierce Deity Link Amiibo, I will definitely shell out for that. And then it ended up just being a young Link holding like a Goron Mask Amiibo. And I was rather disappointed. I was like, ah, that's such a letdown. Because I would have shelled the hell out for a Fierce Deity Link Amiibo. Just like I shelled out for the Revali Amiibo. Or as you saw, three of them. Two of which went to a certain somebody, who we both know. Let's get it going! See, I can relax now, because now I don't have to worry about the rings. I can just be like, okay, I got a ring, I'm good. Yeah, no, the reason I got three was because I was giving two of them to you-know-who to do the giveaway a few months ago. The one that he did on Twitter when the Amiibos came out. What? Boink. Boink. Yep. You got it. That was him. No. Up. Up. Oh, no. Hey. Oh, hey. Never mind. I think I saved it. You know Rev has a Furfany account? That doesn't surprise me. He seems to be very open about talking about, fursuits and stuff lately, so it really doesn't surprise me. Honestly, it wouldn't surprise me if any artist... Obviously not... last I checked, Rev isn't an artist. I don't know, though. I might be wrong. I wouldn't be surprised if any artist had one, because it is a big market. It's a very popular place to show off commissions and stuff and your artistic ability, so, you know, as an artist's tool, I wouldn't single it out just because it caters to a specific demographic of people. As long as it's, you know, not catering to fucking, oh, come on, it's like fucking, like, monsters. And by that, I don't mean, like, animal-type monsters, I mean, you know, human garbage. He only made that count to protect his name? Oh. Well, I know one of my friends actually has the account on there that's named after, I think... I can't remember, but she specifically made it just so the other no one can impersonate them on the website. Oh my god, I'm back down here again. Oh, wait. Okay, I'm missing one more flicky here. Wow, I'm like glancing at this on the streaming screen and the frame rate looks awful. I really wish I could have streamed this in 60 frames per second, but it's too much for my computer to handle. Okay, I just gotta be a little more finessey here. Fuck! My life. Okay. Alright, this shouldn't be too hard. Where is that last flicky? I wish that thing would just go up to the edge instead of, like, near it. Why didn't I land on it? What the hell? This is painful. Oh, wait, I've been up here already. Well, what the fuck? Where's the flicky I'm missing? Oh, no. Yeah, I just have to follow this down a bit. There it is. Now I see why he edited this area to be a little easier. Because that part's torture. Okay, it didn't really help. It's weird, this game feels very maze-like, but at the same time, a lot of these paths you could just go straight up, as long as you have enough momentum. Annoying as shit. There we go. And I went the wrong way. I was supposed to go down first. Well, it's good that you alerted him of that. So at least he doesn't lose the account. Because the problem is, like, now that he's taken the steps to protect it, you know that, like, someone else, like, the second he loses it, someone else will be, like, jumping on top of trying to exploit that. Oh, this is cruel. Okay. So I can't stand in that space for too long. And if I don't jump onto the next thing... Oh my god. Remember when FA didn't have a search function? That was a thing. When was that? I mean, when I was there, when I joined, they already had it. And I joined in, like, 2008, I think, was when I made my account there. Also, I realize I'm just admitting that on stream, and it's like, oh well, who gives a shit? Way back. Oh. Back when Anuvia was still in charge of it. Gene Gadget Act 3, boss time. Okay. What's gonna be the gimmick here? Conveyor belt? It's been 10 years. I mean, it's been about that long for me too, 2008. Though I didn't really start using it regularly until almost 2010, I think. I got it in 2008, didn't really use it until 2009, I believe. And then I didn't... Oh, fucking really? Okay. Or rather, I got it in 2008. And I occasionally used it back when I was dating someone that was using it heavily. And then, shit, why'd I stand there? But I never really used it extensively until like 2010 or so. This is a lot fucking harder than it looks. Death. I'm not wasting that. Not worrying about the time here. It's like so erratic about what hits and what doesn't. See, like that, I feel I should have hit him, but I didn't. So there you go. Fandom sure changed in 10 years. I can only imagine what it must have been like in the early 10s or and 90s. Well, I joined the community in general around 2001 or 2002, and it was kind of in the weird transitional state between what it is now and what it was in the 90s, which makes sense because, you know, it's between the 90s and the 2010s, but let me tell you, 90s furry was really, like, a weird place, because, it was extremely heteronormative as compared to the community now. All the best art was pretty much of big boobed, like Fox Girls. Which, I mean, you know, there's still a lot of that now, but it's definitely not to the same extent it was back then. They all had, like, very comic book style art. Alright. Seventh Zone, Panic Puppet. We'll be able to finish this before the end of the stream. I think after I beat this, I'll call it a night, and then next stream I'll do time attack stuff, and then if I finish that before the end of the stream, maybe I'll do something else. So far, most of the gimmicks seem to be the same as the last zone. There was no flicky in that. What's this? Why is there a switch here? Also, there's the music in the opening, and it's Twinkle Park's music from Sonic Adventure. Time where Jim Hardiman drew most of his stuff? Yes. There you go. Okay. What? Come on, dude. That is a little garbage right there. Not gonna lie. Little garbage. One thing I really miss are the seasonal banners on FA. Oh my god, remember the one Thanksgiving banner that everyone freaked out about? Because it was pretty much, it was like borderline fetish artwork. Hey, there's a flicky over here. Oh, the flickies are just in capsules here. Yeah, that one. You nailed it. Am I back at the beginning? I think I am. Nope, never mind. I'm in a completely different area. Oh my god. Flip the switch. There you go. Yeah, you know, the whole... I don't want to go into discussion about that on stream, but it's like... I think people need to lighten up. It's the whole, if it's not hurting you, then what's the big deal kind of thing? And if it's not hurting anyone, what's the big deal kind of thing? I know that there's kind of a nuance to that mindset where it's like, yeah, well, someone with clearly shitty ideals shouldn't be left to, like, enjoy them. And it's like, yeah, no, that's true. But getting on people's cases about that, of all things, it's just, like, it's dumb. It's really dumb. Alright. That led me back to the beginning. Okay. Oh, wait, no, it didn't. Or it did, because I've gotten these before. Oh, I see. There's a different path here. I didn't think to look over here. Just let me, please, let me bang, let me smash. Bango, got it. Jackpot. Okay, there's a flicky down. Where's the flicky? Where's the flicky? You know, pretend you're XYZZY? Yeah, I've played that before. That's like the furry Cards Against Humanity thing, isn't it? I've played that. Can we not? It's not really furry, they're furry card sets though, yeah, I know. Alright, yeah. So there's more than that. I've only played it with other furries, so yeah. I don't mind if it's tasteful and, you know, not offensive. And by that I don't mean, like, not a dirty joke, but, like, you know, obviously nothing racially charged. Or any of those, you know, hot topics that aren't really up supposed to be up for debate. 40% done, 3 acts to go. I think we could do this before the end of the stream. Whoa, what is that red thing over there? Looks like a rocket. Am I back at the beginning again? Yeah, I am. I just realized there's no flickies here. There's no enemy icons in the corner. This is actually just like a level? That's a big Eggman. Scrambled Eggman. Tink, 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 tink. All right. No. It's weird, there's like a way to like scale up here when you land, but it's like also extremely difficult to do it consistently. It feels like a limit of the engine, really. All the way back to the beginning. Jeez Louise, that is bad. They wanted to change this for the final stage and it's like really not good. I'm disappointed that it's like this now. At least no collecting the flickies. I know, but if I collected the flickies, there'd be checkpoints. Also, where would Knuckles or Tails be on the stage? All the way at the end? That's gonna be rough. Shoes, damn it. Alright. Also, that's another neat little thing they put in the director's cut. If you're moving at max speed, like with the shoes, you won't take damage. When you ram into something, you kind of just get knocked back a bit. There's Tails. Had a feeling that would work. I'm 2 rings short, though. And that closed behind me. Shit. Alright, well. Could have made that a little easier on me. You know, come on now. Now that I know where the rings go, you're gonna do that to me? Such a shit show, yeah. I get the intent, but it's also like, ugh. You're gonna kinda change that up now? Like, that aspect of the game? That's been kinda saving my bacon? I have even less rings than last time. That's cool. Does it carry over? No, I didn't think so. I wouldn't be that lucky. So I pretty much can only lose like 5 rings this entire trip. So, like I said, I can pretty much only lose 5 rings this entire trip. I really hope I don't fuck up the special stage after all this. I really hope I don't fuck up the special stage. That's cool. I mean, that's fine. That's fine. That's cool. 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 Imagine doing this without the shit that they added into that John added into this game. I'm just, I cannot believe myself right now. Am I really this bad? Am I really doing this poorly? Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my god. I've lost all my lives because I'm not even, like... Once I get hit, I give up. I don't know why they had to... Why? Like, why remove the mechanic in this game that makes it playable and do this to you? They just hate you. They just hate you! And I don't know why it's that those two enemies, this every time. Every time, the same two enemies. I should just fuck the shield and not get it, honestly. There it goes. No. Go. Oh my god, thank god I was moving. No, just go. Don't do that to me. No! Come on. Thank God. Now don't fuck this up, please. You have one job, and that's to not fuck this up. Nice. And nice, because I have 69 rings. No! Oh, I fucked it up! I fucked it up! Un-fucking-believable. You know what? You know what? Can I get back in there? 60. That's enough, right? Right? No, it's not. Of course not. God forbid. I hate this game. I cannot believe how badly designed this is. Like, this game was fine, honestly, until this point, and now this is just ruining it. And I can't be bothered to care anymore. There's exactly 60 rings between here and the end, so... I already lost too many. Because I lost 11. I don't even care. I don't even care. Thank you. Thanks. That's cool. That's a great enemy placement right there. One that can just shoot straight at you and fuck you. Oh, pitfall traps too. Nice. Don't introduce those the rest of the game, and they introduce them here. I guess we'll go to Act 3. Okay, so I see a pitfall trap. Okay, that doesn't work. And I'm dead. You know, I think it's been 3 hours, so even though there's only 2 stages left, I still got all the time trials to do, still got another emerald to get, and I still got whatever the hell these extra life things are down here. So why don't... why don't I write down my password, and we'll come back to this either tomorrow, Saturday, or Sunday, and that'll be the last stream of the year. And I'll make that a 3 hour and some odd minute streams to make up for the 15 minutes I'm still short or whatever. How's that sound? And you know, it doesn't matter how it sounds because that's what I'm doing. So let me take a screenshot of that. So I don't forget my password. Now here's my question, what exactly saves when I use one of these passwords? I'd like to see the conclusion, but it's on Saturday, I'm afraid I can't catch it. Well, I'll try to make it tomorrow, because I don't think I'm going anywhere tomorrow evening, so I probably will be here. And I'd rather do it sooner rather than later, so I could just enjoy the rest of the holiday weekend. Instead of having... Because the thing is, I enjoy streaming, but there's also anxiety. It's like, should I stream? If I don't stream today, I gotta stream tomorrow. And then I get lazy, and I don't want to do it. I didn't mean to choose that level. Okay, that's fine. So you start with 4 lives instead of 3. Wait, what? No. I'm gonna quit. You know what? I'll just reset. I could probably just reset the net play, CPU. Really? Country? Hard reset. There it is. Tab. Let's see. Load game. Please enter your save game password. Neat. So... it does save the emeralds, it does save your score, saves your percentage, it saves which stages you've beaten in time attack mode. And that's kinda it. I mean, that's pretty robust, honestly. For a password system, that's pretty good. Nice touch as there's no I's or 1's or 0's, yeah. Alright, I'm gonna stop for tonight. You get some sleep, because it's been a long night for you. What is it, like 4, 6, 5 in the morning over there? I'm gonna move my stuff back to the way it was here. And, that'll be it. Yeah, it's about that. Alright, I'll see you maybe tomorrow, hopefully. You have a great evening. And if you're watching this on YouTube, sorry that this is shorter than a usual video. It's because there was like 20 minutes of technical difficulties at the beginning. Anyway, you have a good night. See ya.